Hello and welcome to Let's Play Legend of Grimrock 2. My name is Zemalf and once again I'll be your gameplay commentator. This time through this dungeon crawling role-playing game that puts me in charge of four prisoners who are shipwrecked in Isle of Nex. Just like the first game, this game has some dungeon crawling gameplay, even that there are some outdoor spaces as well, with a grid-based movement, some highly tactical real-time combat, brain-teasing puzzles and tough enemies I have to deal with, and plenty of secrets and secret switches to find and look for. I am, however, playing this blind, so I don't know if there be any of those things, but those are my expectations, so we'll see what happens. This Let's Play is very much brought to you by the game's developers, Almost Human, as one of them, Juho, contacted me when I was doing the series of the first game, said he was enjoying it a lot, which all by itself was absolutely fantastic and cool, but he was also kind enough to send me the key to this game before the release. I actually bought the game as well, but Juho and others from Almost Human, if you are watching, thank you for making one of my favorite games of all time, Legend of Grimrock, and thank you for this game, and of course, thank you for the key. But without any further ado, let's start a new game. I'll be playing on hard difficulty, creating my own characters. I won't be going with old school mode. I do like the auto map. I won't be using the Iron Man mode, which would only allow me to save at the healing crystals. I might have to stop recording at any moment, so that won't be very good. Sounds like a fun challenge though, as does the single use crystals, but I think I will need the healing, and the hard difficulty all by itself will be a challenge enough for me, so let's go with that. The character creation looks very familiar. We do have one new race. We have Rattling, who seem weak and disease-ridden on the surface, but they are actually one of the most adaptable and hardy creatures in the world. Hoarders by nature, with max load plus 15 kilos. I like that. Immune to diseases, very nice as well. I like these dice here, so I can randomize these things if I want, or that's what I think that will do. Alright, yeah. Pelok, Braveoath. I think that will be my first guy. Ooh, there are new classes. Alchemist. Brew potions. Firearms have less chance to malfunction. Well, that's interesting. Firearms. Speaking of firearms, there are firearms in this game? Alright, so we are definitely in a newer age than the first game. Farmer. As a farmer, you do not command great powers and do not know how to wield a sword. Instead, you are familiar with digging ditches for irrigation and the growth cycles of beetroot plants, basically everything a successful adventurer would never need. What the hell? You receive no skill points at first level. Instead of slaying monsters, you gain experience points by eating food? Sounds like a challenge class to me. I won't be taking any farmers, but that's pretty cool. We have the fighter, which is pretty similar to what it was in the first game. We also have knight, specializing in wielding armor and using the shield. I kinda like that. Maybe I will go with the knight. It was also barbarian. So I'm thinking of maybe making a knight in the front row, Braveoath. And then as the second guy, I will do Minotaur, who will be Barbarian, gaining strength every level. Then maybe in the back row, I will do Rattling, Sangaedolf, Kalo Lozan, I like that. And then I guess I will make a Insectoid Mage, maybe? what is a battle mage? As a battle mage, you are comfortable with fighting in the front row, as well as blasting with spells from the back row. Interesting. Front row mage. Huh. Then we have the normal wizard, I guess. Ah, right. You can cast spells with bare hands. So does that mean that others can cast spells as well? If they have a wand or something, but these mage glasses or magic glasses can cast them with bare hands. Very interesting. What is the alchemist? Herbs in inventory multiply. The growth rate is determined by the number of steps taken. Defend yourself in combat by wielding firearms. I'm kinda thinking of taking one of... I don't know, do I want to use firearms? I definitely want the mage. I guess I will go with the wizard. So I need some willpower. Then maybe vitality with the rest. Dexterity gives accuracy. And strength. Right. More energy. Cheating armor. Strong mind. Quick. That's kind of cool actually, having cooldown period. Like that, but maybe I will pick strong mind. Yeah, strong mind and I guess I will take the magic one, strong mind aura. I kinda want to take an alchemist and have a firearm user, but then I wouldn't have rogue. And I kinda want to have rogue. I guess I won't. So you will be in the back row. One of your attribute scores, chosen randomly, increases by one when you gain a new level. Well, alright, sounds like a good plan. Weapon specialization, melee attacks gain accuracy, strong mind. Natural armor, muscular. Agile, tough, healthy. Endurance, even more carrying capacity, I don't know. Full of rage, damage plus 4. Will that apply in the firearms as well? I don't know. I'm thinking of taking endurance anyway, but maybe some dexterity for accuracy. Does the alchemist... I guess I can still cast spells with this guy. But... I will also be an alchemist. The wizard gains more energy by level, but we still have some, so I'll put some fire, some willpower. Maybe some strength. I don't know, Putting skill points in firearms. So we have a knight, so we'll be using armor and shield. So I guess we'll start with armor. light weapons, heavy weapons. See who will be light weapons. Dual wield light weapons as long as one of them is light. Heavy weapons. Heavy weapons and a shield, maybe? So 2 skill points for starters. Alright, let's put some in strength, some vitality. Because that will be it. Skilled. You gain 1 extra skill point at first level. Oh, first level only. Fast learner. So I'll be even faster? I guess that will be cool. Let's take that. Protection. What was the knights? Protection plus 1 per level. So that will be good anyway. We will be the tank, so maybe I will take healthy instead. The Minotaur. Headhunter for even more strength. Wait, I do want some dexterity to have some accuracy as well. So I can actually hit something. Rage. Your strength is temporarily increased by 10 when you have less than 20% health remaining. That's actually pretty interesting. Taking the racial traits there? I don't know, maybe. Definitely heavy weapons for you. Critical. Alright, that's... alright. Concentration. I guess dodge maybe and armor? I guess I want armor as well. Yeah, probably. Okay, so what about you? Do I want alchemy? I need 4 skill levels to stronger healing potion. Oh, I actually read that I would have to have that to make anything. So I guess you'll be my firearms user. Critical. It looks like I can cast spells a lot more because there's no I'm not gaining the spells as I go on, but instead these just increase the effectiveness of those things. I guess I will make my alchemist a point in alchemy. Fire maybe? Murzan Konmur. Alright, fire mage. Concentration increases your energy. Alright, so that sounds good. Have I put points in everything? 0, 0. Name. So we have Human Knight, Pelok Braveoath, specializing in light weapons. Ah, swords, light weapons. Light weapons and a shield, maybe. And then we have heavy weapons. Yeah, I think that's the way to go. I actually want something else for you than armor, now that I think about it. Athletics increases your health. don't know. I'll just put points in armor because I don't know what to take. Then we have the firearms and alchemy. And then we have fire mage with concentration. Alright, alright. So Murusan Konmur, Sankai Dolph, Kahul Lozan, and Pelok Braveoath. Let's finally start the game that only took me about 10 minutes or 12 minutes to create the characters, but whatever. Let's go. See what the game will give me. Will it give me an cinematic to start the game off? Awesome music. Some Finnish flags, nice. And the music. Good job once again. Loving it. Is this one of us? No. That's us. Four prisoners. Ooh. Looks like the isle draws us in. Why? Shipwrecked. Why? Is it really not by accident that we are here? Well, it is a chance for us prisoners to fight our way through whatever the isle throws at us and maybe, just maybe, escape. I don't know, maybe we'll have to build ourselves a boat and escape this place? Do we want to find out what's on top of the island, on top of that mountain? Yes, I'm very much looking forward to this. The first game became one of my favorites, one of my favorite games of all time, and I really, really liked making the Let's Play as well. And speaking of the first Let's Play, if you have any hints or tips to me in this game, just like in the first series, you have to put them in the comments in a form of riddles. You can't give me downright spoilers, even if you make a riddle, but you can't give me straight out hints in the comments. You have to make them riddles. Right, looks like we have our first puzzle here, and our characters are here, so I can press 1, 2, 3, 4 to check at their stats. Oh, I like that. There are two weapon sets for everyone. But apart from that, it looks very familiar. Yeah. Alright. Well, that did it. So, as you can see, we are moving in a crit here. And we control the group of four. And we can change their order. Whoever is in the front row, if we get attacked from the front, they will take the hits. If we get attacked from the side, whoever is in the side, on that side, will get attacked. And if we get attacked from the behind, the ones in the back row will be attacked. And without any special skills, the ones in the back row can't do melee attacks, but they can cast spells. And spells use runes, just like they did in the first game. I'm expecting to find some scrolls that will tell me how the spells work, but I think I can just try and cast something, and sure enough, that was a fire spell. So just one rune there. Right. And I can of course try out. I guess that worked because I was doing it with the fire mage, and I think that was the same rune it was in the first game. It's been a while since I played the first one, as I don't remember the spells, but if there are same spells, I might actually be able to figure them out, like Fire Shield. Wait, that's... You didn't light them up. I was thinking of selecting two runes, but is it so that I can't select two runes? And it actually reminds me that yes, that's the spell. That's a new as well. I like the interface already in the first game, but it looks like they made it even better in this one. So that's great. Looking for some secrets here, but I don't know. Maybe looking for secrets in the beach is a beast much. There's something horned fruit. This fruit has a very strong sting taste and is commonly found in southern islands. They are covered with needle-like spikes that can easily pierce the skin and cause an irritating rash. But that is a food, however. Alright. See something there. Can I fight these guys? Maybe with fire? Okay. I was thinking of having some food. It's an interesting looking statue right there. Okay, I can't go any further. Can I pick something up here from the water, maybe? This one's down. Yes! Aha, I still got it, but that didn't do anything. Okay, pants. Always good to have pants. Wait, I want to hit those ones down as well. If there's something here to press, I have no idea. So all I can do is click around and maybe that's a bit. Okay, so nothing there. I do like how the game looks. Very nice. And it's kind of a strange feeling seeing sun, you know? Or well, just being outdoors into all this light at least. Seems to be something there. Can I pick these guys up? No. Huh. Looking carefully in the ground if there's something to pick up. That guy probably isn't friendly. Alright. Real-time combats. Alright. Looks like I can still fight with this game pretty well. And I picked up the rock automatically, nice. Alright, so I did find some herbs. Did I give it to a... Yeah, I want to give all the herbs to the alchemist. Just in case. I probably won't be back here at the starting area, so I do want to check it out. I will probably miss something here anyway. that's obviously where I need to go. Right, we have some eggs and we have these turtles here. With the right mouse key I can look around. And apart from that, I'm always moving in a grid based. I don't know, maybe... Do I want to put the arrows there? Just so you can see where I move, if that helps. I'm not going to click them very often, but I don't want to fight these guys, both guys at once. Oh hell. Oh hell. Well, they weren't particularly hard, but I was a little afraid to fight them. If I attack something from behind, I will probably have some bonuses, even without a backstabbing. Backstabbing traits or skills. Alright, alright. Is that a dart? This dart. Alright, so we have some there. I hear something behind the wall. Trap. Okay, I will keep giving my keys to the mage. Just like in the first game, I do want to keep a kind of systematic approach to it. So, whenever I want to find a key, I will just check the inventory of the mage. And I know it's there. And if the key is not there, then I don't have the key. Speaking of which, let's give the food to the Minotaur. I will probably find some bags later on. That will help me manage the inventory a bit. Is that something? No. I'm sure behind one of these hay is something. Something I can use. So that will open with the key. Was there something there? Alright, so I can leave notes here. It looks like this is probably the only way I can go to, so definitely kind of a tutorial here into how to get around. Yeah, it's giving me hints, press tab to check the map and things like that. Looks like we have our first puzzle here. Maybe we'll give the armor to the knight. Looks pretty cool. So I'm going to guess this little puzzle here. Yeah, so I will have to maybe place a rock there. Yeah. Alright, more of the turtles. Okay, they do a little charge. I don't want to get hit by the charge. Too much damage with the mage, so that everyone else gets some experience as well. There's something there, a ladder or something. A rope. Sounds like something... I don't know. I will ask. Sounds like something a mage would use, but... it's a trap. Oh, there's a crystal. What will the letter say? Dear visitor, welcome to my island. I hope your journey was not too detrimental to your health. I think you will find this island to be most wonderful, yet the most perilous place on Earth. I don't have high hopes about your survival, but maybe you can prove me wrong. Better equip yourself before the night falls. Before the night falls, what? The creatures will come out at night. Throwing knives. I was hoping they would have been normal knives, but I take it. Wait, just in case those are herbs, let's keep them there. Can I stack these? No. Scroll of Fireburst, I think that's the spell I already know. Yeah. So I don't need to scroll as long as I know the rune, and I already figured that one on my own. Crystal of Life, touch to heal wounds and restore dead champions back to life. Beware, its power needs time to recharge. I don't need to use it now because I'm all healed up, so I don't need to use it. Come on, game, give me one secret here. Sure, there's something here, but I just don't see it yet. I do have to keep a keen eye on the ground, just in case there's something. I'm quite happy that wasn't an enemy. But this kind of dance is the typical way in the combat of this game. Staying out of the enemies' attacks and making sure you collect everything. Why do I get a feeling you want something there? The item doesn't fit well. Maybe a sword of some sorts? Yeah, well, I definitely know that this. It was pretty obvious that statue wanted something. Alright, and we have some kind of puzzle we need to figure out here. Let's see. X marks the spot. X marks the spot. X in the middle. X marks the spot. So I need to do an X. Is there an X somewhere? Right, of course. Of course. An X. So X. Yeah, that was pretty obvious. Will it stay open? Excellent, will. Thank you. So it wasn't too hard when I actually thought about it a bit. Yeah. Alright. If you need to review the tutorial hints, you can read them from the boss menu. Alright. Whoa! Dude. Oh, nice jump, sir. Look at this guy dancing. And hitting me. Ha I like this guy. I like this guy a lot. Gotcha. Behind you. Not that smart. Not that smart in the end, buddy. Not that smart. These knives are flying long, long way. Alright, I've been playing for about a half an hour here. About a half an hour in addition to my intro. The second most precious thing in life for a seafaring captain is his sword, because without it he cannot command his crew. Thus, upon losing his weapon somewhere on the shipwreck beach, he lost what is most important to him, the respect of his crew. Shipwreck beach. So did I miss something? Something in the beach? Not these, I'm sure. A sword, maybe? Yeah, it must be a sword. Anyway, I think I will end the part 1 here, and I will continue in the part 2. If you are new to my channel, please consider subscribing to the channel for notifications when I post new videos. I plan to get back to my actual daily videos. And also, if you like this video, if you like Legend of Grimrock, do hit the like button on this video. It helps me make more. But without any further ado, when I deal with this guy, I will end the video and continue into part 2. Wow. So much for dancing. These guys take some time. Anyway, I thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.